Hello, everyone, anyone, and welcome back to Divinity, Original Sin, Enhanced Edition. Okay, I got back to saying all cool and sounding like. Took me a little bit. I am your host, Ziyal, and I am spreading out some of these effing resurrection scrolls because I need to. I forgot that people were running out of them. Seamus has all of them. You got one? Do you have a couple? You got a couple, right? Ziyal, I got one. One's fine. I should buy more eventually. Bloody, 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 blah. Anyway, but that's the boring stuff. Let me tell you about the cool stuff I did in between episodes. Long story short, I figured out I still didn't get him a new hat. I did go shopping though, and I did do some leveling up. What I do by shopping, our good friend Jahan. And by good friend, I mean some jerk I know, can master the power of the storm. 8 targets randomly, and this lasts for 2 turns. So, that's awesome. I kind of feel like since it costs 11 freaking AP, kind of a good starting off battle. Like, if you can be away from the combat when it starts, you know, you cast a little rain, so then that way they can electrify the surface, and then you can make it so that something is wet and causes problems. Beyond that, I did nothing. I once again tried to do Tenebrium weapons. If you want to upgrade your use crafting to put Tenebrium on weapons of all those bars you got, I hope you have skill points, or I do it on a secondary character because you need enhanced Tenebrium skill just to be able to freaking do it. So that sucks. Bear Daughter! She's boring. She got more in her defenses. She needed it, and that is all I will say about the matter. Other than that was basically my choice, is to give her a little bit more defenses. Seamus, I gave him leadership. His leadership goes up to 5 because of all the cool stuff he has. Oh, apparently if I can get up to 6 even, I can get more. So that's cool. Something to consider, because it gives you bodybuilding. But that way I'm giving a willpower bonus to everybody, except for Seamus, but he can deal. He'll be fine. He's the sturdiest son of a gun I know. Beyond that, I finally remembered I had like 3 copies of Shackle of Pain, which is something I definitely want to use on him, because he's going to be taking a beating, and they can distribute that damage amongst themselves, the jerks. Beyond that, Ziyal was boring as well. Boom, bonuses to willpower and bodybuilding. Boring slash done. Oh, and Jahan got a nice robe because immediately being knocked down is good for him because he's going to get knocked down. One of the other things I happened across was I did remember that somebody else had a effing moonstone on them. Did I pass it over him or not? Oh, I just want to vomit every time I look at this inventory. I know that's how you guys are like, oh, that's what we've been saying. It's like, yeah, but I'm going to ask it, you know, shut up. No. what did I give the moonstone to? Here it is. I gave it to Ziyal for some matter. All right. Moonstone. Your stupid staff. Crafting belt on. Go. Your stupid staff. Oh, and that apparently did have moonstones. I was just blind. Boom. Improved staff. Yeah, it's improved. It does more damage now, I think. That's all I really noticed. I should have looked at it before. But the idea behind this is that a skill that used to be worthless, which is Staff of the Tempest, was pretty effing useless before, but now it's got a use in case I want to do some air damage or something. I have the ability to do so. Attack a ground target. Huh. Anyway. And that is the gist of all my stuff. I was going to go say, hey, let's go play with the Death Knights, but no. They're closed and they don't want to play. Bunch of jerks. Oh, yeah. I kind of forgot to pick up that Ice Rain book, but I can't open it up. In fact, actually, that is what we're going to do. We are going to... It might be a little out of order, but we got to figure out what's going on with the whole end of time, because do we want that place to be on fire constantly? No. Mainly because it annoys me. Like, it annoys the heck out of me. He said something about there being 3 paths going forward. That looks awful. And one of them had a bunch of immaculates. You know me, I'm all about slain immaculates. And one of them, they're going to be immune to Tenebrium or something like that. But we'll deal with these things as it goes. But we might be going a little out of order for things. But I'll be darned if I want to keep dealing with the End of Time being a fiery war zone of terribleness that makes me sad. And all of God's creatures. So, to the forest we go. They actually call this... Seriously? More of you jerks? Immaculate Priest? Huh. I thought this is the way to Hunter's Edge. It's not up here, right? Actually, it might be up there. We'll try going through there first, before we get in any combat. Because I might have paid that one troll off just because he had his kid with him. Bring your, you know, son or daughter to work day and play to my sympathies. Jerk. You know, which I may yet go back and slay all of them. I mean, let's be 100% honest about that. Unless I'm just going to the magma path, but I was pretty sure this is the way to Hunter's Edge, right? Because, ew. Tangleweed. Ew. Spiders. This looks safe. Let's go through here.
Our enemies have laid a trap.
Really? I don't see it. There it is.
Here, I heard this was a place of many people, so here I came. I have seen more faces here in a day than I had seen in all the days of my life together.
Oh, good.
But I have not found the face I seek. Jarrett is missing. It is my duty to find him.
Oh, yeah. Where is he going to be?
That mystery is thick and ugly as a swarm of hornets.
Mm-hmm.
It started with a great disturbance in Home Forest. A terrible disease came in the night and turned the birds and beasts soft and foul as carrion while they still lived.
I'm trying to remember if we talked about this before, but she just started talking to me or I misclicked on her.
I watched countless of my loved ones die, rotted from the inside. When I ran to Jarrett to tell him what I had seen, his reaction was strange. He had no answer.
Oh,
the next
yeah,
morning, Jarrett did not emerge from his room. I left him be. But after 3 days, I grew anxious. I broke down the door, and inside his chamber was nothing. His equipment, his books, all but some scraps of parchment were gone.
Gone?
He was kidnapped, and all his research was taken with him. The only clue I found was a letter among the scraps. I could not make out all the words, but I recognized the threat. Death coming for you. And the signature? Attenborough. I do not know the one called Attenborough, but I know that if I am to find Jarrett, I must start there. Whoever this Attenborough may be, I believe he or she may know where Jarrett has been taken.
Sounds Scottish. I either misclicked on her, I don't know exactly what happened. Hey, let's just trap disarm this so we don't exploit the tangleweed. Boom. Hurrah. Do I have to? Oh, there's another one over there, you see that? Let's explode the tangleweed because I'm bored. I'm bored of this conversation. Where is it? Where'd it go? Right there. Yeah, explosions and stuff. I don't even know where we lost HP, but we did it.
Liquid courage.
Yeah. What a weird way to put that, buddy. But we got rid of some of this here tangleweedo, and of course rain. I could put rain on.
Rainfall.
Other people should probably do
that. Them for a dry shirt.
They love that. They think that line is just the best. And they will say it every time they have an opportunity to. What? More of you guys? Oh my god, tangleweed is everywhere. Gray noxious bulb. Don't
I need a remedy!
Oh! Fudge! Yeah! Her daughter, give her a light!
I can see the white light!
I lost her anyway. I lost everyone. I'm so sad. Well, and they continued on. The ladies had fallen. They were a little sad by it for a moment. And then I remembered. Probably should have just cast this instead. That's a much smarter plan. Did you just step on, like, another? That'd be great if I, like, resurrected her on top of a, exploding whatever. Yeah! Great decision I made there. So those... See, I never actually... If I would have interacted with them before, I would have realized these are bad. We shouldn't do this. But I didn't. So, yippee-ki-yay. And the heal game continues. Every time, I gotta tell you, if we had a drinking game, you'd have to watch episodes in a row. But if you watch especially the early episodes, drinking game every time you use a resurrection scroll, my god, there'd be lawsuits from all the damage that anyone would have caused to their friends, neighbors, and loved ones.
A stitch in time, eh,
my friend? Is everyone healed up? Are you good? Good. Fantastic. Quicksave. Hello. Hi. My name is Quicksave.
I'm drenched.
No. It's truly awful. It's a town. There's a, no. No. Oh. You all know what's coming. Cat puns. But we made our way to this town. Oh, dead people. Hello. Hi.
Oh, there. A word of warning, Wanderer, before you continue on your merry way.
Mm-hmm.
See these corpses here? Be a good fellow and take them as a hint that this town isn't the pastoral little paradise it once was. That.
He has a great equip. Whoa. Of the brute. Looks awesome. I want it. Give it to me. I'm rich. I could just take it from him, I suppose, but you have any Tenebrium weapons by chance, bro? No? Mm-hmm.
Immaculates, yeah. Orcs and humans both have taken Hunter's Edge. Its villagers are now slaves in the mines of the west, or they've been bled dry of their last drop of life, reduced to mere fuel that must light the wicked candle that is Bloodstone.
Oh, man.
Long as you live in the limbo between coming and going, though, why not have a look at what I have to sell? You'd be surprised to see what a scouring skeleton can gather together in a dying town.
It's true. Anything vital I need now?
Yeah. Well, don't go round angering immaculates if you want to keep your vitals intact.
I'm not afraid of those.
Though
this
perhaps it won't be very long before they have a stab at one another's vitals instead. I have the feeling there's trouble brewing between the orcs and the humans in there, and who can blame them, really? Just ain't natural for them to consort, I say. Only good orc. Well, you know how the phrase goes.
It's racist. Who are you?
Can't say I remember who I was before the change came over me. But these days, I'm a traveling trader of sorts. There's an immaculate necromancer in the village ahead. She's the one who brought me back from, well, wherever I was. She's an especially bright one, you know. Most necromancers can only revive a dead corpse into an animated one, but she manages to yank back some semblance of consciousness, too. I don't remember much, but the thrill of trade certainly calls to me. Maybe I was a merchant in my former life. Who knows?
Who knows?
These days, most undead are busy haunting Syseal or picking the way in the Lucula mines. But I keep a low profile and stay out of sight. Haven't been bothered by an immaculate yet, and I hope to keep it that way.
Hey, I met a skeleton just like you.
I know the weapons of which you speak. I've even hidden away a piece of one myself. I had planned to pass it down to my son, but... Well, maybe you could make better use of it now.
Do you remember your son? Cool. Oh, no, don't do that. They get really mad when you take your son.
A cold drink.
My, you're still alive.
Yes.
Way to beat the odds, Wanderer.
Thanks, buddy. You're real. See, look, even these shells unlock skills. The shield does, but I still wanted the mace. Or the thing at the time. Now I'm just talking about the mace. This mace is awesome, but I'm going to lose leadership for it. That's also good, because I think, actually, if I recall correctly, I think he's still wearing the panties of better trading. Mm-hmm, yes. Perception, leadership, sneaking. I mean, there's better helmets all around. I mean, there's stuff I should probably find and equip and all that sort of stuff, but we're okay on this sort of thing. But he does have some nice things. In fact, fancy feathers, he's got creepy. He's got all the stuff to make some cool stuff. You can dye your armor and all that cool rigmarole, one of those. All right, I have waited around long enough. Oh, it's Arhu. Hi.
How can I help you, my friend?
Okay.
Come on, time's a wasting.
Yeah. You still sell the same things? Yeah. I don't know. Some madman was in the way.
You. Come on, time's a wasting.
Is that the cat talking? Yeah, so what about Xandalore and Wishsellers? Okay, no, I've already talked to him. What are you doing here?
I'm watching on with weary eyes how the Immaculates strike again. They've gone from shedding blood among their own to recruiting orcs and cutthroats to do it for them. From what I can tell, the village of Hunter's Edge is this cult's most wretched victim.
We discovered.
It was once a quiet sort of village. Families and small-time merchants mostly. Recently, it was targeted by a tribe of orcs waving the Immaculate Banner.
Jerks.
Their leader, Grutilda, is known far and wide for her cruelty and cunning. She oversaw the murder of countless villagers and used their blood to fuel a great number of bloodstones. Once they were dead, they were reanimated as undead corpses and sent to work in the mines of Lakula.
All right.
By order of Leandra, the orcs were joined by a tribe of humans from the northern peaks of Tanneroth. A band of male warriors are they, and they devote allegiance to their leader, Jarl.
Ha! Do you get it?
Jarl arrived with his own formidable supply of bloodstones, which means his tribe has been operating under directions from the conduit for some time. Where once they ransacked for base pleasure and material gain, now they do it by the will of the goddess.
Yeah.
These are far from the blindly devoted Immaculates of Silverglen, however. The orcs and the humans here alternate between bitter fighting and hostile peace. Personally, I believe they're best exploited through their rivalry. Get them to fight each other, and you can stand on the sidelines and warm yourself upon the flames.
Cool. Xandalore lives here. Do you have any pointers?
He has a residence at the far end of town. Though I have my doubts he's having people over for tea now that the Immaculates have landed.
Oh.
Know that Xandalore is wily, so beware. If a wizard doesn't want you in his home, you'll know it. Pity the intruder that heedlessly tries to waltz his way into that dwelling.
I see.
Nevertheless, his house is the very place you'll want to search. The accumulated knowledge stored there is quite phenomenal, and beyond a doubt, one of Leandra's most urgent pursuits.
Cool. Yeah, we were talking about this.
Ah, yes, that was...
Yeah. So, yeah, what is going on, Kat?
You can speak.
Yeah.
You don't look like a tribesman or orc, but I suppose I can't be certain. Then again, I've never heard of a dark soul gifted with the speech of the wild.
Well, what can I say? I'm friends of all the pets.
Jinxica is my name. Mm-hmm. And until recently, I lived a placid sort of life among the people of Hunter's Edge. The baker might leave me a bit of milk left over from this breakfast. The barkeep stroked my back between filling glasses. I had many friends here, but none so dear as a little trio. A married pair and their daughter, employed by the wizard to keep his home. They spent many long hours squashing fleas that plagued me and shared their warm beds with me each night. If you come to this village to help and not to harm, you might be able to save those three kind souls from the orcs that have invaded. Ugh, such misery in our sad town.
What do you know about this wizard?
A kind but private man he is. He set up his home here several years ago, but never remained there long enough before jetting off to tend to some matter or other. The dark invaders seem very interested in him indeed. They've been skulking around outside the house since they arrived, but not even one of their filthy vermin can penetrate the wizard's protective enchantments.
The orcs invaded, huh?
Would that an invasion were all! They destroyed every crumb of life they could find and sent their filthy rats to seek out those who evaded them. Each life they took infused their strange stones with power. Their queen glowed with delight as a parade of victims were slain before her. It was as though she was taking in a beautiful song.
Wow.
The human tribe came shortly after. They had their own supply of the glowing stones, and the orc queen took no easy liking to them. Still, it seems they are working towards some similar goal. They haven't destroyed one another yet.
Yeah, so much friends, servants.
They've survived this carnage so far by concealing themselves most cleverly. I've done my best to guard their hiding place from the slime-bellied rats attempting to sniff them out. But I fear my efforts aren't enough. Until the village has been rid of vermin, those three sweet souls may be found at any time.
They're using rats to their advantage?
Savages by savages employed. The orcs have one among them. The rat catcher, they call him, who claims to have trained rats to do his bidding. They've swarmed the place in search of hidden villagers, and unless every last one of them is split from tail to snout, they're sure to find my friends.
Oh.
But you're not like the brutes inside those walls. No, you approached me with hand, not boot outstretched. Perhaps you could help me. With these rats running about, it's only a matter of time before my friends are caught.
Right.
They must be squashed, every last one of them. I've done my best so far, but there are simply too many for one set of claws to handle. With your help, though, with your help, it could be done. The rats gone, my friends safe.
That's a heck of a speech there. I like it.
Just a few yards of intestine.
Oh, that bothersome old Tom. No, he and I are hardly friendly, much less friends. I've much more important things on my mind than him and his incessant pestering.
Ha ha! Burn, RQ! This pussycat doesn't want any of your tomfoolery.
I can slip through these walls as I please. But you'll need to find your own way into the village.
Mm-hmm.
And remember, my friend, kill every last rat you find, or three dear souls will be lost.
Okay. So, the village is that away. All right. Arhu, ha ha ha, she doesn't like you. I'm laughing at your pain. Laughing at your pain, are you? Okay, so what? Places to go, places to be.
Warm as baking like a cake.
And I get to kill rats? Oh. Mountain warriors, huh? This is supposed to be the town. Alright, well I think we'll try breaking in come next episode, just because I feel like killing tonight. Yeah. No, I just feel like I want to kind of get a feel for the power of the creatures in the forest compared to my own.
I'd prefer to drown my sorrows with ale.
Yes. But I don't even know how that happened. Is there like some bad guys over here somewhere?
It never rains.
Bad guys. Hello. Donde está los bandidos? Was there like some like, you know, spiders with spidery things? Where was those? We died around here. Yeah, okay, so there's some spiders or something like it right here. Right? Wasn't there? Am I just hallucinating? Oh, no, it wasn't. Okay, Mr. Krabs, if that is your real name. Mm-hmm. What to do? It's been a while, my old friend. And I'll make sure I pop this, and fast track our way to freedom for the next round. Alright, now we have ourselves an interesting dilemma. We gain 7 points per turn, meaning that to get 11 points, we need to have 7 plus, 4 as 11. So we need to make sure that we have 4 points remaining by the time we're finished here. That will be too much. That will be more than enough. Too many. So really, our best bet is to go with either buffs or something, so if we want to cast our cool spell, or have a skeleton friend. Yeah, whatever. Just hit him instead. There we go. And this, if I did my math right, we should be okay. Assuming he doesn't get stunned or something like that. Alrighty. Bear daughter. You got lots of nasty enemies around here. But we're gonna do the same thing. And I'm just gonna move to summon everything. I haven't done that in a while. So, summons! These things are awfully... These things are giving me kind of the creeps too, what can I say? What do you got? What? That's a bollocks, if I've ever seen it. Just curse to everybody? Wow. It's a heck of a move. Uh-huh. Yep, chance to hit's lowered. Ding! They're hitting pretty hard-ish. Yeah, it's kind of all relative, but she stood there, watching, waiting. No man would know what she would do. This mud huntress was her own woman thing. She was. I'm trying. I got nothing in the tank today, what can I say? Where are you going? Well, I suppose if you really want to flank that badly. My god. Hi, I'm a spider. Wow, these things are hard to hit. Oh yeah, I'm cursed. Dupe. I'm stupid. I come from a land of stupids. I come from a land down under. Men are in and women chunda. Alright, best way to deal with cursed. Bless everybody! And you're blessed, and you're blessed, and you're blessed. By my book.
Bless my stars.
Bless my stars indeed. Let's get you closer into the fray, my friend. Everyone's blessed that will counteract the cursedness. Or actually, just gets rid of curse, doesn't it? Never mind, it's even better than I thought. Stab! Okay, make a bleed. Alright. And yeah, okay.
If this battle be my last, no, I went out fighting in your name.
Throw your foot. Yeah. Oops. Whatever. Nick, you're just so awesome.
Bless the seven, I am restored.
What she said. Alright, so we have options as usual. We can move here for 5, which will be just fine. I'll walk through poison though. Is there any way not to walk through poison? Not really. Just walk through the poison. Okay. It'll be fine. They healed with the blood. It's kind of a wash, but whatever. Attack! They have decent armor, don't they? That's a lot of damage I'm doing to her. So, and she's knocked down. Hey, 100% chance now that she's knocked down, buddy. Go, you wonderful spider, you. Okay. Yep, same deal. She also, is it also frozen? Is it frozen and knocked down? That was joking. Oh, good enough. All right, now, see, that's the problem, though. Is that it's only within this area. And this is really not the ideal time to do it. I can think of several reasons why I shouldn't be doing this. But I can only think of one reason why it's only hitting 2 people. Maybe it'll hit this one over here. Yeah, you're casting it. Because I want to do it.
I strike from the eye of the storm.
Yeah! Oh! Yeah, buddy. If that was random... How is that random? You just nuked the heck out of the thing on the ground. Whatever. You know what? It was still cool. Okay? You're lucky that it was really cool. Alright. Because it was. And shoot. Call a spade a spade. Hi. Hello, mister. Yeah, I'll take the 92% chance. Wow. Way to make me look. Come on, that is good odds. Nice.
I think I'll go for the eyes this time.
Damn you, Nick. I swear, you were clicking the right thing. Now he's stunned. Oh, well. Look, he provided him. He did his job. He's a wonderful shield. Ow. Man, they're really loving to bypass. Look. And as soon as they take off the immunity to stunned equipment, look what happens to Seamus. That's a pity. You gonna try to crawl the infestation, my buddy here? I don't think so. Hi. Can't see. Because there's this cool looking storm. I mean, that's definitely an enhanced edition effect. Is a cool looking storm. Let's get real close. Tell me your innermost secrets. Whoa. Okay, don't get that close. That is really bad on my eyes hurt after all that. Am I immune to stun? Let's find out. Maybe. Yeah, snicker, snicker, snicker. She's probably gonna have to go for bully. Bully would be an ideal pickup for her to do some damage in the future. These guys, they got a lot of hit points. What can I say? Hi. Hello. Brr. Critical hit. Brr. Hi. Yep. Okay. Dude, that is so not random, but I love it. I'm sure the math is gonna be like, no, actually, you could have done more damage if you would have and such. But, bibbidi bobbidi boom, I made him explode. I mean, Jahan can go up melee. Do it! Melee him! Okay. I hate. Oh, fudgers. Alright, that was a misclick, obviously. And I should have unstunned Sheamus and yada 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 yada. Hey, you thought about your move this time. Am I gonna regret this? Is Bear Daughter gonna die? No. Oh, good. Hit Jahan. Yeah. Pin him again. He has learned his lesson. One more time. Not Bear Daughter. Oh. Are you faking me out? All right. Let's see. That's not 20%. I don't have enough to do it now. I could do it next turn, but. For 10 action points, it's probably just going to be better just to try to finish them off this way. And why don't we get ourselves moving up in the air, just in case. Hi, spider! Brr. Brr. One more time. Oh, okay. Yeah, don't do that again. although, you need to experience... Have I told you about the joys of being frozen in place? I have. Oh. And unfreeze Sheamus. Okay. Okay. Now, hit him. Oh. Fine. Be like that.
A million tiny pieces.
So, is that your autobiography? Okay.
Seven revitalized me through this puppet.
Yep.
Would you Sounds care good. To hear a little tale?
It's not dead. It's funny. Oh, that was supposed to be, that sounded like a knockdown effect, didn't it? Yay! these things are snipers. Okay, so I have learned a valuable lesson about, I don't know, friendship or something. I learned something. Hammer time. That's what I learned. That saying hammer time is a lot of fun. Strike it. That was my valuable lesson. Murderize.
Eternal silence awaits you.
Blinder when you can.
What's this, if you can?
And why don't we summon your good buddy? Hello, how you doing? And move back to deal with that guy. Alrighty. John can just get experience later. Yeah, screw him. Let's just do some damage while we have the opportunity. I'm in the right stance. Fire. Mm-hmm. Okay, you're back up, are you? Sorry, what was that? I couldn't quite hear you over this. Good times. Put on your elemental tortoise powers. Because we're going to test things in the next one. Alright, if I explode here, I hurt everybody. So let's go... There we go. Seamus. How much is Seamus going to take? Boom! Next to nothing. Combat log. I don't know why it's so far down. Go a little bit long. Create a fire. Using fire on blood. Succumb to death. Mild Hunter. Seamus is burning. Somehow he got healed, but I have no idea. Whatever. Point is, he's fine. Nothing to worry about. Nothing to see here. Everything's A-okay. Moving here. It's anyways more efficient.
Trick of Twilight.
Twick of Twilight. Wascally Wabbit. Everyone, to look at Jahan's grave, which is somewhere over here. Remember when he died? These are good times, weren't they? Not really. Some of this is just like you can do more damage just by shooting some of the gun, yeah. I'd have guaranteed damage instead of missing potentially with other attacks, but is what it is. If you kill Bear Daughter, then I will write a formal essay about why that was bad and why I shouldn't have done what I done. I'm so sorry, Jahan. Did you really fall
Something
over?
Something toxic courses through my veins.
Yeah. Hey, buddy. How's it going?
Die, vermin!
And we all learn a valuable lesson. And Jahan's dead. Look at him. Look at him. Doesn't even have a gravestone. He's just sitting lying there on the ground. Alright, so thank you very much for watching this episode of Any Original Sin. We'll resurrect Jahan, you know, if we get around to it. In the next episode, thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed, please leave a like. It's basically the lifeblood of the channel. And I will see you in the next episode. Take care, y'all. Be well.